It's G-Civil here. Welcome back to the show. Today we're going to talk about some very interesting things that you might not have thought of. The spiritual blood. So you see, blood type, right? If you want to give blood to people, you need to match the type that they have in order to help them. If you put in something that is not compatible, then something not good will happen. There are some blood type, like the O type, right? It's like more neutral. It can mix with anything, kind of thing like that. Religiously, spiritually, there's also something like this. Your spiritual energy. When you are born, okay? Let's say you have no religion. Your family, you have no religion, okay? No whatsoever. Then you're more like a neutral type. The neutral type is like you can go into anything and dive into it, and it's fine. You start off like at zero and then you keep building up, right? You can mostly like go here, go here, go here, and nothing much will happen to you. At the same time, this is actually the weakest type, the type that can be easily attacked. So if someone else with a religious practice or background, they try to attack you, curse you, do something on you, then you will get affected right away. It's very fragile. But at the same time, if you enter a religion, okay, let's say this religion right here, then your blood type change when you get initiated or whatever you want to call that, you enter that religion, their energy mixes into your system and changes your spiritual blood type to that type. And that is why you can now use the things in that system, such as their magic, their prayers, and anything like that. However, if you decided to change from this to another religion, there goes the problem. You're no longer neutral, right? So you want to go into a new system and take this blood type and mix it into yourself. If you have not cleansed out all the old blood before you accept this one, then something might happen. The blood type will crash and you will see a lot of problems comes up. It could be the new religion not working out for you, or the old religion giving you a lot of hurdles, struggles, problems, and things like that. So when people come to me and say, I want to get ordained, I can accept disciples with multiple paths and different backgrounds at the first place. But I always tell them, eventually, you got to make up your mind. Because you have to wash out the old in order to hold on to the new. Or if you try to mix for a long time, eventually something will crash. Also, the more pure your spiritual blood type is, the more powerful that blood is. So if you're doing like Taoist magic in our sect, if your blood type is purely our type of power, it will be more powerful than those who mix this with other things. The more you mix, the more impure it is, the less powerful it gets. That's how it is. So, wait a minute. Now we know about the spiritual blood type. You got to be aware of this. If someone, okay, let's say there's this guy who is a Catholic, believe in Jesus and all that. And then you, let's say, is a Buddhist. You have the Buddhist blood type on you. The Catholic guy comes over and say, oh, let me pray for you. Let me give you blessings. Oh God, please help him. Okay. Now all that Catholic power, blood, is coming over to you, the Buddhist. It's trying to mix into your system. You see, maybe this guy is having like a good intention, really want to help you, really a nice guy by the heart. But because the blood type is not compatible, his so-called blessing is now a virus, a toxic ingredient for your system. When this thing mixed into you, it doesn't help. It harms. So we as a Taoist, when people like go like, oh, God bless you and whatever, right? They try to like give us blessings. We always say no, thanks. Okay? We always say no. I don't give people our power if they don't ask for it. Because who knows what they have, right? If they are like a Buddhist, a Muslim, or whatever, they have their own blood. Just because you want to help, and then you try to like inject your blood to all those people, are you actually helping or are you actually harming? It is actually a way to harm people. You are screwing up their spiritual blood. So what can we do? Do not go around and just poke your blood into everyone. If they are neutral, they have nothing at the back, that's good. We can give them some of our blood so they can get help. So you might say, well, does that mean that if someone is like with a religion, then they cannot get help from the Taoism source? Not really. We can actually help them get rid of the harmful ingredient without putting our blood onto them. So instead of working on the person, you can work on the evil thing or the threat that is bothering them. But eventually, the problem is, think about it. If you are like with a certain blood type, you're in a religion, how come you will be having so many problems that lead you to want help from the other sources outside? Ask yourself in the heart, it's because the religion you're in right now cannot help you. That's why you're seeking help from other sources. You already lose faith in your religion, and it means that your religion doesn't work for you. And that's normal, because not everyone fit in this or that religion. It really depends on your own blood and see like how you work out with this or that. So if you're in a certain religion and you tried it for a few years and you still have a lot of problems, it means that you guys don't work. It's time to get out of it and then go somewhere that might work for you. So this might open you up to think about what you should really be learning or going for. Anyway, if you have more questions, leave in the comment section below, and I'll see you in the next one.